What's up, you guys? Welcome back to my channel. Welcome to Sundays with Malz. If you're here, please hashtag Sundays with Malz. Let's make it a thing. Like I said earlier, I'm sorry for skipping out on the last Sunday video because, I mean, what happened? Oh yeah, I went on this weekend trip. Let me talk about it in this video. I had a really nice, fun week, which I'm going to talk to you about. Also in this video, I'm going to try out all the products that I spoke about in my sale video. The summer sale video. All these products are right here. So I'm just going to be getting ready with you, talking about stuff. I have a few questions that I can answer for you guys. So let's quickly begin in no particular order. Okay, first I'm drinking lassi because garmi mein it's good, yeah. Do you feel like having lassi now? Do ya? Good. Go harass your mother and tell her to make you a lassi. My mom made this for me. Dude, my mom's a brilliant cook. Like, I'm literally getting fat. Like, no jokes, bro. Like, I have never gone above 52 kgs. I'm 55 kgs right now. Legit. So you can see I'm putting on weight. But I'm still lean. I'm putting on good weight. I feel like I was too skinny earlier. Like, you know, I was like, like you could see my bones coming out and stuff. But now I feel like I'm in a good place. You know, I love my weight. I love the way I'm looking. I know I have to go to the gym and all to tone it up, which I'm going to go. I do go for kickboxing, but I've taken a break. I'm gonna join the gym now for a bit and focus on toning up my body a little more. So now that I have all this extra mass, I can like work with it. Dude, Bob is like gown. This is no makeup, by the way. I just filmed a video, so I just took my makeup off. I have to moisturize and stuff, but this is without makeup, okay? Look at this, guys. I'm coming as close as I can. Bob has gone. Like, no blemish, nothing. There's like this little thing, it'll go in like a few days. Dude, my skin doctor is a freaking genius. I feel like she has magic in her hands. I'm gonna leave her details down below. Check her out if you're in the Bombay area. If you live in Bombay or if you're away and you have like skin problems, like major skin issues, fly down here, man. Like, she's so good. I'm not even joking. I'm not getting paid to say any of this. Like, nothing. What good would it do to me? But if anything is good, I want to mention it for you guys. And she's helped my skin so much. Like, basically, he and she have two doctors, Dr. Jitesh Shetty and Umaira Sheikh. And the clinic is called Tvam. I've mentioned this so many times. It's in Lokhandwala market. What is happening to the light? So yeah, you can see, dude, my skin. You know how much I was suffering, right, with Bob, Steve and Dave. Like, there were three big zits here and it completely, like, it was really bad, okay? It was like cystic. It was hurting me. So I ran to her as and when I got time and she did her face cleanup. So I get the anti-acne face cleanup, okay? If you're ever going to her, ask about me, ask about what I get. She'll totally tell you. I just get like a facial, like an anti-acne facial, and then she goes in with her instruments and she gets all of it out. It is a painful process, I'm not going to lie, but I have done it for over 6 years now. I've done this, so my face is used to that pain. Like, I know what's going to come. So initially I couldn't bear it at all. Like, my face used to burn. But she does put like a what do you say, like a numbing cream all over your face. So if you have like really heavy acne, she'll put like a numbing cream. And if you can bear the pain a little bit, guys, dude, it's going to help you. Clearly, look at this. I'm so happy my skin is back to normal. I think it was a combination of a lot of things, like I got this zit after like I don't even know how many months, okay? And it was that time of the month and like too much makeup, too much sweat and heat. So my skin was getting too clogged, you know, and it just attacked me. But I'm happy I'm back. I changed my hair color, like you can see. This is like a rich mahogany brown. I don't have the exact color, but it's like a rich mahogany brown. I darkened my ends and my roots. I did not want the blonde anymore. It was making my hair look really weak. So yeah, I love my hair color. Whoever I've met, I've just been obsessed. I went to Nalini and Yasmin in Bandra, and the owner itself, like, she colored my hair. Her name is Natasha. So if you go there, ask for her. I got it done through Vela. I work with Vela, so they wanted to get my hair colored and any color choice, so I picked this mahogany and I wanted to do it for quite some time now. So yeah, I'm very lucky that they wanted to color my hair, but definitely, guys, it is worth everything. It's so yummy. Like, my hair color when I see it, I'm just like this chocolatey rich. It has a reddish undertone, which is so beautiful. Oh my god, I'm talking too much. If you're here for the first time, my Sunday videos are hella long. They're 30 minutes, 40 minutes. They're super long. This is for my subscribers who love to watch me without makeup, get ready, be myself completely. And this is me and this is for them. So if you're here for the first time and wondering like, why is this video 40 minutes long? Is she doing a short film? No, that's just what, it's a series. It's called Sundays with Mals. And yeah, welcome, welcome. I hope you enjoy. People say I'm funny. I hope I make you laugh today. Okay, so let's get ready, my loves, and I'm going to answer your questions as well. I'm doing too many things. I'm eating salad, this is salad, and I'm drinking and I'm wearing makeup and I'm answering your questions, so bear with me right here. The first thing I'm going to do, I'm just going to moisturize my skin, okay, because I just got done filming an Instagram video, so I'm just going to hydrate. Okay, let me talk about my weekend while I'm moisturizing. So it was Mother's Day weekend. I hope you guys had a really nice time with your mommies. I enjoyed my weekend so much, okay? So I was in this, I won't say rut, but I was in this very weird working zone. Like I was constantly, why is it getting so bright, girl? So I was in this very heavy working zone, okay? I was doing too many things in one day and the heat and my skin caught up to me and I'm just like, I just want to run away. Sometimes you feel like that, okay? Even if you're, because I work from home and it's the best thing on this planet, trust me. I would never want to travel for work every day, but it's like I was just getting too, you know, right? Just like, I don't know the word for it. I was tired, I was exhausted mentally, and I was like, I just needed to run away for 2 days where it's just relaxing and nothing else. I wanted to do nothing. Okay, so I decided to, I wanted to take a trip. I wanted to go to Goa, Bangkok. I saw all of that and I'm just like, dude, I have ton of work, okay? So if I have to travel somewhere, my work will be pending so much. And if I'm going to Goa, Bangkok, I need to go for like a week. I can't go for like 2-3 days. Okay, let me wear foundation. I'm wearing the Wet n Wild cushion foundation. This is very dark for me, but you guys wanted to, I promised you I'd wear it. Can you see? It's very, very dark. This is very dark for me and I cannot work with this even because after I'm wearing like an open thing. See now how dark it is, but it's very moisturizing. Can you see? So if you get this in your shade, it's a good foundation. I just wanted to show you that. Okay, I'm gonna take the Makeup Revolution stick once again to show you how it works. Absolutely love this. I put this in my favorites. Yeah, so I wanted to like run away and I'm just like, I need this weekend off, okay? I have to go somewhere. So I thought, why not do a staycation? Now for all of you who don't know what a staycation is, it's like going for a vacation in your city, like in your hometown, not somewhere far away. So I thought I'll just book a room for my mom and me, and it was Mother's Day and she was also very tired. She's like, I need a break, you know, I need some, I just want to go out for a bit. So I'm like, why not both of us just take the weekend off? Because my brothers were in Dubai, Akhil's in Germany. So I'm like, you know, it's just the two of us, let's just do this mother-daughter weekend. That's what I did. I booked a hotel at the Lalit. I got a really good price at Make My Trip. And yeah, I just booked two nights. So Friday, so it was Saturday, Sunday and Monday back. So I went, you guys saw my Insta story. If you follow me there, I'm sure you must have seen all the fun that I had. And it was so nice doing nothing, guys. Like there was AC 24/7 in the room. And like, I love hotel rooms, okay? I am obsessed with hotel rooms. I can live in hotel rooms for a really, really, really long time, even forever. Yeah, I'm a little obsessed with hotel rooms, hotel bathrooms. The first thing I do is go to a hotel bathroom and see what's up because I love bathrooms. Is that weird? Is that just me? I'm sure most of you do too. And we were just like, I just wanted to be in the room. I didn't necessarily want to go out partying and all. It was like a relaxing weekend, you know? Try this sometimes if you like, are on a budget and just want to go like in the same city. Dude, literally it felt like we were in like Goa or something, like literally, because the Lalit is so big. And you know, when you're staying in that hotel zone, there's a pool, there are like tourists, you feel like you're somewhere else. So we stayed in the hotel room mostly. We watched TV, we talked, we played music, we put our sheet masks on. There were so many things that we did and I loved it. I loved it so much. I'm gonna do this more often. I feel like this is something I love doing. I just fell in love with the whole staycation idea. What's up with Delight though? Oh yeah, I got the CC cream. Oh God, I should have tried that. Maybe I'll try this sometime else. I'm not gonna put concealer because I'm not going anywhere. The story of my life, bro. I get ready and I sit at home That's just how it is, because I get ready at like 3 and 4. I'm just gonna put the foundation as concealer. In my recent current favorite video, I'm wearing the Huda Beauty makeup and all. That's why it's so heavy. Like some of you were saying, oh my god, there's too much makeup. Because I shot that for the eyeshadow palette. Actually, I did not want to sit down and film with that makeup, but I would not be able to remove the makeup, put makeup and sit again. So I said, why not just film with the makeup I have? I know it was too much, but that was for Instagram and for pictures. It was not how I usually get ready. That's too much makeup. And yeah, the lashes were a little off. I totally agree with that. You know, my right eyelash was like drooping. There was an issue with the lash. Like, I checked again and again to see what's the problem, but I also genuinely felt that the Sasha lashes, one were like separated and the other one was like drooping down. I don't know, I think I got like a not the right batch or something, I'm not sure. There was something wrong with the lashes, that I will give you. I know, I figured that out in my picture as well, so just letting you know, just addressing this little problem. But I'm not perfect, yeah. Like, I feel like now there's so much expectation, I have to be perfect. I can't have anything wrong going on in my pictures, you know, and video, and it's just like, especially pictures, video though, I don't care, but in my pictures and all, I'm like scrutinized, I feel sometimes, you know, when your following increases, a lot of people who don't know you join you for the first time, they immediately start judging you, they're just like, oh my god, your eyebrows are weird, you know, like, why are you smoothening out your picture so much, what is wrong with this light? So a lot of people are like, why are you smoothening out your picture so much? Like, oh my god, I've been doing the same edit since the beginning of my page. And I don't know what is new. I got Facetune recently. I saw Manny and James Charles. I never use Facetune. I use YouCam. But I saw Facetune and I loved Facetune. You can actually add stuff to your makeup. Like, you know, when I'm clicking pictures and the highlighter is so booming in person, it can't translate on camera. Like, sometimes you cannot see the glitter. Like, the Huda Beauty eyeshadow, it was coming off pretty but not as pretty in person. Like, it was so gorgeous in person, it was not translating. So Facetune is an app where you can emphasize your makeup. It's more so for beauty bloggers and beauty pictures. You can sort of do a light touch on the eyeshadow and it sort of enhances the eyeshadow more. It's not like cheating or like I'm not doing anything to sort of give you false advertisement. I would never do that, you guys know that. But just to make it a pretty picture, to make it look like a beauty shot, because I'm taking a professional beauty shot. It's not like a selfie. You know, on a selfie, I wouldn't do all of that. It's a professional beauty shot with makeup brands tagged in it. And every single beauty blogger does it. Like, every single. I started doing this like 1 week ago. You know, just enhancing my highlighter, just touching it a little bit so it comes out the way it actually is in person. So it's not false advertisement and all. Like, don't go on that, you know, because some things you have to do to keep up your profile. Baki to you see me, yeah, how I am. I have nothing to hide. That's the last thing I would do, like hide and all of that. Even saying it, I feel like laughing because I'm like, you guys know me, man. Like, I would never do anything to, like, you know.
I will not do cheating. This I'll tell you. Cheating I will not do.
And I smoothen out my picture a little bit. Yes, I do, because when we click pictures in natural light, I take my pictures in natural lighting. There's no artificial lights for my Insta pictures. It's only sunlight, and this camera is very good quality and it captures every single detail, okay? It captures pores, it captures everything. Not that there's anything wrong with having pores and all, but who wants a pory picture? Pory. Who wants a picture with a lot of emphasized pores and all? I don't have many. Basically, the idea is to have a pretty picture because of beauty brands and stuff. So I just like smoothen out over here a little bit, a little bit on my nose. And baki though, I have good skin, so I don't really care. So these are very little things, guys. And this is the blogging world, and this is how Instagram works. If you see other Instagram pictures, oh geez, it's too much. It's good, like it's extra smooth. But I'm not against all of that. Like, I don't know why people take offense to it and be like, why do you smooth your picture so much? Why do you edit your picture so much? Like, kya bolu main? I don't even want to justify it because I feel like it's so stupid even saying these things, because a lot of people don't understand this industry. You know, yes, over editing, over smoothening and resizing, reshaping, all of that, yeah, I get it, how it can, you know, give you like a false image and all, but a little bit of touch up and to emphasize the makeup, there's nothing wrong with that, guys. It's like making a presentation good when you're in college or work. You sort of put pictures, you put stickers, you know, you enhance it a little more so it looks presentable. That's all. My makeup is super time pass. I'm not focusing on like powdering and all. I'm just being very relaxed, okay? It's Sunday, bro. Okay, let me eat my kakdi. Okay, I'm taking this shade and this shade and I'm putting it in my crease. Oh, that's pigmented. Okay, that's gorgeous. For Lakme, like, sorry, I don't use Lakme makeup a lot, but I think I should. That's why I ordered this palette. I wanted to really, really try, you know, these brands. That's pigmented, dude. I've been watching a lot of Netflix shows and I've been really, really loving Safe. Please watch Safe. It's a British TV show on Netflix and it's so good. I really, really like it. But I can tell you that it is so beautiful. It's so bloody beautiful. I can't stop this accent. What am I supposed to do? Okay, bas ho gaya abhi. Let's come down to earth, bhai. Such messy makeup, I don't even focus on it right now. I'm like doing my makeup like an amateur. One kiss is all it takes. Falling in love with me. Possibility. One kiss is all it takes. Okay, I'm gonna take one of these shimmer shades. I don't know which one. I think the champagne shade. It's not the best shimmer, I can tell you that. Okay, so I'm gonna answer some questions from Instagram and then I'm gonna continue getting ready. The first question is by my friend. they're so funny. So it's by Sneh. She's my bestie. We've been friends for like, I don't even know, like 10 years, even longer than that. Like way too long, okay? It's like we grew up together, like our teenage years and stuff. So she was Jay's friend, my older brother, and then we became such good friends. She's basically my sister. I don't even want to call her my friend because, you know, when you're so close to someone, you just become family. That's it. She has a lot of questions. How much do you love me? A shit ton. Like, I'd do anything for you. I love you so much. Who's your BFF besides your mom and Akhil? I feel like this is mean. She's like, you don't have best friends. Just Akhil and your mom are your best friends. But apart from that, look, this is what I'm telling you. I don't have friends. Well, I don't want to say she's my best friend. Like I said, she's my family. She's my sister. It's way more than a friend. When are we celebrating my birthday? We already went out yesterday. How many more times do you want me to go? Will you cook for me if I knew how to? When are we doing our video? Super soon. I'm gonna film with Sneh. She's the girl you saw in my Maybelline video. So I'm gonna film with her really soon. She's super creative, super fun, super funny. And we get along really well. Okay, next question. What is your favorite cartoon as a child? I loved Tom and Jerry and Scooby-Doo. Yeah. I remember vividly watching Scooby-Doo all the time and Tom and Jerry is something that it's so close to my heart. What is your favorite workout wear? I love to wear pants, those really like tight fitted pants, and I like to wear like a loose t-shirt, like basically my brother's t-shirt or my boyfriend's t-shirt. I don't like to wear tight clothes and I wear a sports bra inside. Hey Malvika, you're beautiful. Thank you, girl. I saw your vlog with your boyfriend. Thanks. I don't know, it's your boyfriend. I still feel like I don't know why. It's been so long, still I'm like all shy. So I've been talking to this guy for a few months and I had my first kiss, girl. Few days back I asked him what were we, and he said he hasn't given it a thought. Boys, I tell you. So I've been heartbroken ever since. Why? I just wanted to explain how to overcome this type of feeling, and I know there are tons of people facing heartbreak. So you have a really great relationship, touchwood, please help. I'm sure a lot of people would want to know what to do when a guy says he's not ready for some relationship. Damn. Okay, girl, firstly, heartbreak is a big thing. Like, you guys just kissed for the first time and you can't have a heartbreak. Like, heartbreak involves like, matlab usne, he's your boyfriend, usne kuch kiya hai, toh like cheating, or he's lied to you, or you know, that is heartbreak. You can't have a heartbreak in such a small thing. Yeah, I'm gonna be like a mother to you now. No heartbreaks. Yeah, he's just first kiss, give him a break. Yeah, cut the guy some slack. I feel like boys mature very like later on in their life. I think we mature super soon and we understand things emotionally, physically. We're so much more intelligent when it comes to relationships, I feel like. Like, they do stuff, they kiss you and they be like, no, I don't know, we'll see, I'm not ready for a relationship. Okay, that's cool. That's cool. The more you sort of hammer them, the more you go after them, be like, listen, but I love you, but you kissed me. I understand, like, first kisses and, like, you know, everything first is like, you really get attached to the guy. But what I've learned over the time is just like, you cannot pay too much attention to that. Like, the more you pay attention, the more you give him importance and be like, listen, no, please, like, they just run away, guys. They repel. That's what happens to boys. They are wired like that. They don't like to commit. Like, I'm not saying all boys, but initial thoughts of all boys are like, no, no, commitment, girlfriend, like, no, how is this? So they get really scared. So try and understand from their perspective. And if he's just not interested, if it was just a one-time thing, if it's not gotten that serious with him yet, I'm sure eventually, you know, you will give away. Like, you'll just move away, basically. When some guy doesn't give you attention for a really long time, your heart just basically gives up and is like, you know what, I got other things to do, I don't need you. Because you're just gonna waste your time when there are so many other guys there who are just so much willing and wanting your attention even more. So I think you should not being a very relationshipy mother kind of a thing, but I think you should sort of stay away for a bit. Don't give him too much attention and don't be after him, because guys get like that sometimes. It's just a boy thing. It's just boy thing in general. Okay, I have two blushes here. One is Rose d'Oro and one is Luminoso from Milani. So I'm just gonna like use Luminoso because I love it. Okay, so let's talk about money for a second, yeah? Okay, I'm having green tea and we're talking about money. I've been through a lot of phases in my life financially where I can finally talk about money. We've been really, really, really poor at one point. Then we picked up and I've been really, really, really rich. That's the point where I didn't start my YouTube channel. This was all just before I started my YouTube channel. It was the life. If I had a YouTube channel back then, you would actually see all of it. We used to travel a lot. We used to travel the world. We had fancy cars. Like, we had it down to the T. It was a good life, and I'm not gonna say I was ridiculously happy. I loved the trips. I was in a very happy place at that point. I had my own room. Like, it was a good life, okay? It was a really good life. And then again, things went south. Like it happens with most families, you know, a lot of shit happens, and I'm not gonna get really personal because I never do. But again, things fell down and we had to, I mean, it's not the worst situation. Like, for us, it was because we were just still growing up and figuring life out. But shit happens. It happens to most families, and that's how life is. And I think I've matured a lot ever since that whole episode, ever since everything happened for me. Like, a lot of people don't know behind the cameras what happens. Like, I always tell you guys, like, you think this is only my life and other YouTubers' life, but you have no freaking idea what happens behind the camera, and that's fine. I don't intend to bring all of my sadness in front of you, and no YouTuber wants to do that, you know. Like, that's why we're constantly, like, at least I am constantly positive, because I want to send out positivity to you guys. So yeah, again, it just came to a phase where it wasn't the best place of my life, and these 2-3 years have been really difficult. They have been like the most difficult years in 25 years of my life, and it still is. Some days they're difficult, some days they're good days. We have good and bad days. So yeah, when it comes to, is money, like, sorry I'm taking so long to answer the question, but that's Sundays with Mars. I go on an off topic. But yeah, that's what it's all about, you know. I feel like, does money give you happiness? Yes. I'm not gonna be like very, you know, bookish and be like, no, money can't give you happiness. I'm not gonna say that. If I had a shit ton of money, would I be happy today? Absolutely. Like, I'm not gonna say no. So money gives you peace of mind. You have satisfaction. You don't have to worry about anything. Like, you know, you're taken care of. Like, in that space, you're happy, yes. Is it the only thing that makes you happy? No. Okay, so it's not the only thing. Like, today, if I had a shit ton of money and if I had nobody to share it with, if I had no family, everybody went away, if I had no love, like nothing, would I be happy? Absolutely not. I would be down in the ditch. No amount of money can make up for love in your life. I'll give you that. Like, I can have $1 billion today and have no love and still be like a shit person, like absolutely in the drain, because it has to be in balance, I feel like. So yeah, answering your question, have a lot of money or always feel happy, I think it goes hand in hand. It's like in conjunction together. I feel like having good relationships and having money, both are like, now don't quote me in a wrong way, don't get me wrong, don't be like, I need money to be happy. It's a very controversial topic, I feel like, for a lot of people. But you understand what I'm trying to say, right? Like, I don't, if I was like really, really poor and I didn't have money, would I be happy? No. That's the honest fact of it. You know, you need money to have peace of mind, you know, to know that you're taken care of. So that gives you internal happiness, okay? As a change of setup, you guys wanted to see Jake. So here he is.
What's up?
He was in Dubai and now he's back.
Yeah.
Okay, we're gonna answer some questions. Who was mom and dad's favorite kid or something when you were
when I was a kid, then me only, you know, obviously.
No, I don't know what the question was, but I think Jake is the favorite of my parents and I think of us also. I don't mind that, but he is the little one, so he's, that's scrubby. Share your first kiss story, Jake. So awkward. No, no, I want to know. It's okay. We talk about this shit. You tell.
You asked for mine.
No, it's both of us.
Okay, my first kiss story. Okay, wait. I actually don't know what I'm talking about. Let me at least think of it.
Don't make up shit, huh?
No, no. As far as I know.
How old were you? Don't say 9, I'll kill you.
No, it was in grade 7.
What? Mom, if you're watching.
I don't remember how old
14 when you're in 10th. 14, 13, 12. Like 9, bro! How did you know you were supposed to kiss at 9?
I don't know, just like it just happened. And then
nothing just happened.
And then I like realized that I was like, oh shit, wait, I know what happened. And then it just took off from there.
Do you talk to her still?
No, no, I don't even know who she was. Like, I don't know her name anymore.
What a player!
It was like years ago.
You don't even know her name anymore. Dude, you're such a player. Oh my god. Basically, this is the player qualities you can find out. This is it. Yeah, mine was a Rakhil only, guys, like 100 years ago. Okay, next question.
No, but when was your first kiss, they asked?
With Rakhil.
Are you, but when? Like when you were 12, when you were
10? Oh, when I was 17.
That's a long time.
I know, it's been like 9 years. So when I was 17, it was too late. Yeah, you thought it at 9 years. Is it Yanni or is it Laurel?
It's Laurel.
Yanni!
It's Laurel.
Let's play it. Laurel.
It's Laurel.
Yanni!
Laurel.
Yanni!
Laurel.
It's Yanni. Agony Yanni now. When are you deciding to get married? I'm making up my own question.
I am not gonna let her get married till 30.
What? Yeah. Minimum. Even I don't think I want to get married till like a long time.
See, it goes through me, so. But when I decide, I'm like, okay, fine, you can get married.
Can.
Maybe you can't.
But they're asking when you want to get married.
When I want to get married. I don't want to get married.
That's what all boys say. All boys say this.
But
boy says this.
But I want to have kids before I get married.
Dun dun dun.
Thrown out of the society.
Can you act like me?
Yeah, I can act like you.
Like, what do you mean? No.
This is me. And then this is Miles. And I'm like, hey Miles, see this, see this. Wait. Yeah. She legit can't see. She can't see anything.
But I can't see.
Can't you see? I can't see.
No, guys, I can't see without my glasses, and I'm without my glasses at home most
legit
of the time.
Legit, anything you want to show her, she's like,
I don't do it with a hand shaking. What rubbish. Is Jake single?
Yeah.
Now was it?
No one. That's
lies, lies. That's why he doesn't want me to ask where you're going every time. Okay, guys. Now he has to go and work, and I got Jake for you guys because you wanted to see, and y'all were harassing me. Okay, bye. So yeah, thank you so much for watching, guys. I will see you in my next video. I love you so much. Be good, learn to love yourself, love everyone around you, and yeah, I'll see you in the next one.